talking about non-farm feedstocks, the Michigan State University built the largest digestion system on a U.S. campus. What is it about?
So the digester that we built on campus is a complete mixed digester that utilizes dairy manure from the campus dairy, as well as food waste from our cafeterias. And we serve about 150,000 meals a week. So we have a relatively large food service component to campus. But then we partnered with outside suppliers of feedstock, so supermarkets and milk processing factories and fats, oils, and grease haulers to take in other feedstocks to really get to the size that we're at, which is about, we process about 22 to 24,000 tons a year material and generate continuously about 400 kilowatts of electricity.
What are the benefits for the campus?
Well, campus has two plans that are the benefits. One, a sustainability plan, where we're looking to essentially avoid landfilling, you know, organic waste as well as recyclables. And so it gave us an outlet for organic waste that we didn't have prior to the digester. And then the other is part of our energy transition plan. So in 2012, we set a target to be 15% renewable by 2015, and also have a reduction of greenhouse gas emissions. And the construction of the digester was the first project to address those on campus. And so we're now working on a solar array that'll also generate renewable energy, but the digester provides both benefit to the sustainability plan as well as the energy transition plan.
How are the electricity and the heat produced used?
So again, the university is a large campus, 50 some thousand students total. And so we have a pretty large energy demand. So the electricity that's produced is tied into campus, and we provide power to 10 different buildings. If we were to send it all into main campus, it would provide enough energy for one of our dorms that houses about 1,700 students. The heat is used to maintain the digester and heat the supporting buildings around. There's a research complex, the solid liquid separator, but we don't use the heat beyond that, and it's just because it's isolated that it wouldn't be cost effective to use that heat elsewhere.
And what about the funding of this project?
So funding the project was done internally. So we have an MSU foundation that provided capital for the project. And then the project has expectations to pay back that capital with some interest over the next 10 years to the foundation.